So, another day, another guitar, and this time it's a Tanglewood. I've reviewed a few Tanglewoods on this site, and this is one of their premier Exoctic series guitars. To give it its proper name, it is a TPE SFCE DS. So there. I call it Wally because, well, it's made of walnut. It comes in four versions. You've got the ZS, which is Zebrano, LS, Lacewood, AS is ash, and DS for walnut. Who knows why? Anyway, here's what it sounds like. You're hearing it through a Shure microphone at the moment, and just acoustically. Designed for finger picking, being a folk guitar rather than strumming, but I've added a scratch plate because occasionally I do like to take up my plectrum and, as they say locally, gie it laldy. Okay, so what's it like as we go up the neck? Does it keep its tuning? And in that chord progression there, the first, second and sixth strings were all open all the way up, and the other three were the ones that changed. And that gives you a good indication as to whether things are okay as you get up the top, which they are. Intonation. Now, actual construction-wise, what do I have to say? Well, the neck profile is really good. It's very, very comfortable, very smooth. Really impressed with that. Bizarrely, I actually had to raise the action on this guitar. Yeah, I know. Usually you have to lower them. But this one, it was set okay for a light finger-picking style, but for use with the plectrum, as I did there, it was a wee bit rattly, so I popped in a higher saddle at the tail end there. There's two ways of doing that. I happen to have a house full of guitar bits, so I had a saddle that I could modify to put in. The other way to do it, of course, is to just put a wee shim under the existing saddle, if you have that problem. And where do you get a shim? An old credit card would do. Store card, yeah, just take a wee slice off that, pop it underneath, and then put your bridge back in. The one thing to check though is, once you've done it, is the string balance still okay on the pickup? That's something that you have to check. Pickup, right, okay, so as you look at the guitar, guitars with pickups usually have preamp somewhere, and this one doesn't seem to. Until you look very closely inside the sound hole, where you will see something that maybe looks a bit like Mick Jagger's lower lip. Yeah, that big red thing, yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, that's it. It's lurking in here, and the battery is in a little pouch which is attached to the neck block underneath here. Now, what you've got is... you've got volume at this end, there's a phase switch, and then there's bass and treble nearest the fingerboard end there. So what I'll do is I'll turn the mic down and I'll turn the pickup up so that what you'll hear is the pickup. And I'll make a few adjustments just to give you an idea of the tone range that we have. It's a B-band pickup. So there you have it. Good machine heads. Satin finish overall. Satin allows the best sound of the guitar to come out, but it is slightly more vulnerable to being knocked off bits of furniture. It's more likely to mark. And when you're recording using the pickup, there can be a slight noise as you move. If you live in a part of the world where woolly jumpers are required, then you can pick up a little bit of surface noise on satin that you wouldn't get on gloss. You overcome that by, rolling up your sleeve. It's as simple as that. I had to make one modification to it. Well, I didn't have to. It wasn't desperate. But when picking up the guitar, I felt that the fret ends were just a wee bit jaggy. It didn't get in the way of my playing. They were just a wee bit on the rough side. Just remembering to let you hear what it sounds like with a capo. So what I did was sanding block, a bit of 1500 grit sandpaper, a sort of thing you'll get down your car dealership for doing the paintwork on cars, and just spent 2 minutes each side going up and down with that, and that's it. Absolutely perfect now. It's not something you would have to do, but it might be something that you would choose. In the shop where I bought this, they had most of the range, and I tried the ash bodied one and the lacewood one, and this one, the walnut one, was the warmest sounding of the three. The other two were perfectly good, perfectly nice guitars. If you happen to like a bright sound, then they would, maybe the ash would be the one to go for. If you like a warmer sound, closer to what we'd associate with mahogany, then this one, the walnut, would be the weapon of choice. So there you go. Oh, and walnut, a legal high.